Now we are going to say discuss about observer design pattern theory principles, real life examples and real time examples. In the next video we will try to cover observer design pattern practical implementation using Java. So before discussing about observer design pattern, I will try to convey some information regarding software design patterns book. So many people ask me regarding the software design patterns book, which is the best book and where can I buy that, like that. So the best book information would be provided at the description box of this video. You can click on that link for buying the book on online itself. So let's dive into the software design pattern. One of the important design patterns under software design pattern is observer design pattern. So first we will try to relate the cover a real-time example where observer design pattern is playing a major role. So if suppose if you are trying to buy a smart TV on online, so this is a smart TV. So nowadays many people are buying the electrical gadgets on online. So this is the one of the important gadgets that people are willing to buy. So because of huge demand, the product availability has become less. So the online shopping sites are trying to follow another strategy called flash sale. So they are trying to sell the most demanded products on flash sale. So flash sale means, so the flash sale will last only for 2 to 3 seconds. So if you are lucky, you could buy this product at that time. So the flash sale would be available on every week or on every month, on monthly or weekly basis. If suppose if 4 people are willing to buy this product, so this is one, second one, third and fourth one, these 4 people are trying to buy this product, but for the first time they have failed to buy this product because of stock unavailability. So what they are trying to do is they are trying to register with this product on that online site. So whenever this product is available, then the notification would be sent to these people. So this subject will send the notification to the registered people. So here we can relate the smart TV as a subject and these people as observers. So these people are observing something. These people are trying to buy the product. So they have registered with this subject. Whenever the product is available, that notification will be sent to this observers. So these are the observers. We are trying to buy some product and we are trying to register with them. So here, first observer, second observer, third observer, fourth observer. The first observer doesn't know the information about the second observer. Second observer doesn't know the information about the third observer. But all the information would be available under for subject. So A, B, C, D. So this A, B, C, D are the observers. A, B, C, D. Subject would hold the observer IDs, which means A ID, B ID, C ID, D ID. Subject won't hold all the information about all the observers. So subject won't hold the observer name, observer details, observer city, observer previous purchase details, like that. Subject would hold only the observer IDs. So this is the example where observer design pattern is playing a major role in real life scenarios. We will try to relate these points with the example. So first one is behavioral design pattern. Behavioral design pattern, this observer design pattern falls under behavioral design pattern. The reason behind that is it behaves based on some state. And then second point is object or subject maintains all its dependents called observers. So here this is a subject or object which maintains all the information about which holds the information about all the observers. Here it holds only the information about the observers as observer IDs. So it holds the observer A ID, observer B ID, observer C ID and observer D ID. It won't hold the observer A personal information like name and the other stuff. It holds just the ID for communication. And then one to many dependency between objects. One object changes state and all its dependents are notified and updated automatically. So this is the subject. If suppose this subject is changed from unavailability to availability state, then all the observers, which means all the objects which are registered to this subject, would be notified. That is this point, one to many dependency between objects. One object changes state and all these dependents are notified and updated automatically. And another point is, subject or publisher doesn't need to know anything about observers or listeners. So I already talked about that point in the while explaining the example. Subject doesn't maintain all the information about all the observers. Like, it won't maintain the observer A personal data like name, age, date of birth, and other stuff. Subject would hold only the observer A ID. That's it. And then very loose coupling here. A, B, C, D are observers. They are linked with the subject. So here one to many dependency, subject one and observers are many. So it's a very, very loose coupling. And then limitation. So subject or publisher may send updates that don't make sense to the observers. For example, if these are the four observers, if A observer has already bought this product on another online site. Since A has registered with this subject on another site, this site would send the notification regarding this product availability on weekly or monthly basis. Those notifications are irrelevant to this observer. So this is one of these limitations, but this limitation can be overcome by using some other methods. So we will try to cover those things in the upcoming videos. So subject may send updates that don't make sense to the observers. So thanks for watching this video.